the same chassis. So you can see the chassis here is very similar. But the big difference with that welder and what makes it so unique in the industry is it is the only welder. So nobody else makes a welder that welds to the right. This welder welds to the left. This welder welds to the left. All our competitors' welders weld to the left and under the chassis because they use the chassis to place the weight on your weld. Well, this actually has a cantilevered system where it takes the weight and shoves it to the outside wheel here and allows the weight to be that within 0.8 inch of a pitch change. So whether it's a pipe boot like this, or if this was a skylight and we had flashing coming off the skylight, you put an outside corner on there, you pre-tack your outside corner on your flashing, and just make a skirt all the way around it, and just softball cut that outside corner. So you can do a radius, and this will go right around the skylight, depending on how big. I mean, you can do a skylight in 4.5 minutes. You got a guy pre-prepping it, bring this along, and just clamp them out. So when you get jobs where you got multiple skylights, and you know you're going to have a detail crew on for multiple days, you bring one of these out and you get them off the roof 2 days early. So I'm going to show you now how this actually can do a pipe boot. But one of the key reasons why this can do radiuses is not only that it welds to the outside, but it actually has a locking hub. So this welder works fine for doing overlaps. If I want to do an overlap, I have this wheel locked in, and my welder doesn't want to turn, it just wants to go straight. So I'm doing a regular overlap weld. And then if I'm going to do a boot, I unlock this hub, and now my welder will turn. And it guides itself around these, just as simple as if you're welding in a normal straight line. So the casters on the front on this and on the regular rip-on are used mainly just for positioning your welder to your applications on the roof. Get them in place, drop your casters down, and now you're ready to weld. Typically with a membrane that's warm like this, you can weld one of these boots in about 26 seconds. So just like you're doing a normal overlap, once you place your heat source in, this is going to start moving, and all I'm doing is just guiding it. Now this tool actually is in every GAF plant for training now. All the training facilities use a roof on edge. And then Carlisle actually has a lot of our tools on their site as well. All the manufacturers have seen and experienced our tools and approved them for their members. Now, as with any tool, you kind of got to get it set up and count and what you're doing. But now, if I wanted to take and just do a regular overlap and application, I just add a little. Turn my machine around. This is an overlap. Lock my hub in. It's got a regular pizza cutter like all your newer the guy's wheel. It doesn't overlap just like any of your other welders. So very versatile. This machine can easily run, you know, 100 square, 70 square job without having to bring a big tool on the roof. So, as with any tool, whenever you're using it, you need to let it heat up, and then you need to bring it down. So I'm going to do this on the boot real quick. Show you one more time. So again, I've got this locked, I unlock it, drop my tool, guide around. Usually the applications I've seen where you guys get a lot of pipe roof where a tool like this will pay for itself, apartment buildings or dormitories. So there you have it, that's done. Seconds rather than minutes. And your guy wouldn't have to be on his hands and knees. I'll set this up and quick we'll do a simulation of it and keep it on up. Okay. So the reason this one works is it actually has a